They allowed him to eat a plate of cold beans and drink rust-colored water from a tin can at a picnic table outside. One guy with an AR-15 stood a short distance away, watching Michael's every move. Rusty sat on the other side of the table. Michael had counted a total of 4 men. Once he was free from his bonds and outdoors, Michael could see that the place was likely an old hunting cabin, the kind that Jake had been tracking. It appeared to be a century old. There was no electricity, hence the lamps inside. He had noticed that they'd filled his cup with water from a pump at the side of the house. That meant there was no running water, either. A dirt road led away from the place through thick trees. In fact, woodlands surrounded the property. He was really deep in it somewhere.
"See how easy this is? Be cool and all goes well," Rusty said.
Michael nodded.
"Good. We want our special guest to be happy. We want to keep those 5-star reviews coming."
The others laughed at their leader's wit.
"So what's this all about?" Michael asked.
Rusty grinned.
"He can speak in complete sentences."
"You have me here for a reason."
"What's going on?" Michael snapped.
"All right, no harm in telling you. Even if you do make it out of here alive. Your boss is in Richmond, Virginia. He's at a hearing that really matters to some friends of ours. We're going to know 2 days from now how that hearing goes for you. If your Mr. Boss Man wins, you lose. If he loses, your chances get a lot better. All you are right now, pal, is insurance that Mr. Big Lawyer drops a lawsuit against our good friends, no matter which way that judge decides."
"He'll never drop the case."
"Then you won't live to see Friday if he doesn't. You done with your lunch? Tasty, huh? All right, we're going back inside. We're going to zip-tie your wrists, but if you're a good boy, we'll let you lie down. It's just like it is up in Rikers. If you behave, you get privileges. If you don't, then hell rains down. Don't worry, we'll always be here to make sure you don't get too comfortable. And one more thing. I need the pin to get into your cell phone, and it's probably not worth it to you for us to have to beat it out of you, so just give it up. Don't worry, I won't look at your personal stuff. I just need to send a text message from you. Okay, off you go."
He looked at the man with the long rifle.
"Smitty, take him inside."